This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to solve this right triangle. Solving a right triangle means you can state what the three angles of the triangle are and what the three sides of the triangle are. And we actually know three of those things already. So we need to know the three angles. I'm just going to call those angles A, B, and C since that's the way they're labeled. And we also need to know the sides. All right, now the convention is if you have an angle A, then we're going to call the side opposite little a. So we also need to know the side opposite A, the side opposite B will be lowercase b, and the side opposite angle C will be lowercase c. Now, what am I given? I'm given in this picture that A is 40 degrees. So this is known. I know it's a right triangle, and that's at C, so that I know that angle C is 90 degrees. And what else am I given? I'm given that this side over here, this line segment BC, but what do we call that? That's called lowercase a, because it's opposite angle A. All right, so we know that side A, even though you don't see it listed that way, is 8.3. All right, so where would little b be? It's across from angle B, so this is little b, and C is the hypotenuse. It's across from the 90 degree angle. So we're given three things, and we need to find the other three things. Now, angle B is the easiest one to do first because I know what angle A is. It's 40 degrees, and I know these two angles have to add up to 90. So B must be 50 degrees. Now I need to find B, side B, and side C. And I'm going to use trig to do that. I'm going to use my trig functions, either the sine, the cosine, or the tangent. All right, so how about if I want to deal with this angle 40 degrees? I know that now this is 50 degrees. I can use the angle 50 degrees, or I could use the angle 40 degrees. Let's say I want to deal with this angle 40 degrees, and I know the side opposite of that is 8.3. So I'm thinking, what trig function will I be dealing with the side opposite? Well, that could be the sine or the tangent. The sine of A, in other words, the sine of 40 degrees, right? The sine of this angle A, is the side opposite, well, the side opposite is given as 8.3 over the hypotenuse, and the hypotenuse is C. And now we have an algebraic equation with just one variable missing. So we could use algebra to solve for C. You could have used tangent of 40 degrees as well, because the tangent involves the side opposite. You want to use the side that's given. All right, so the tangent of 40 degrees is the side opposite over the side adjacent. So the side opposite is 8.3, and the side adjacent is B. Again, we have an algebraic equation with just one variable. Now, what if you had tried using the cosine of 40 degrees? The cosine is the side adjacent over the hypotenuse, B over C. We would have had trouble here because we don't know B and we don't know C, so we wouldn't get anywhere with the cosine. So we could have used the sine or the tangent. Now, if instead I wanted to deal with the 50 degree angle, then I could have used the cosine, because that would have given me the side adjacent, 8.3 over C, or I could have used the tangent, which will be B over 8.3. So there's four choices you might have used. I decided to use the 40 degree angle. All right, so now I want you to try this. How would you solve for C? So you could use your calculator. The sine of 40 degrees equals 8.3 over C. What would you do to solve for C? Well, you should get that C, and I'll show the steps. Multiply both sides by C. That means you get C times the sine of 40 degrees on the on the right-hand side, and then it would cancel on the right-hand side, right, if you multiply that by c. So we would have the sine c times the sine of 40 degrees equals 8.3. Now remember, sine of 40 degrees is just some constant, like, you know, who knows what it is. You can look it up in your calculator. So I'm just going to divide by the constant on both sides of the equation so I could solve for c. And that I'm going to put in my calculator, and I'm going to round to the nearest tenth. Since this side was to the nearest tenth, I'm going to round the side here to the nearest tenth as well. So in your calculator, you want to put 8.3 divided by sine of 40 degrees, and make sure that your calculator is in degree mode. And if you do that and you round it, you should get 12.9. So C, which is the hypotenuse here, is about 12.9. So I'm going to write, it's approximately, let's see, how about if I, C is approximately 12.9. All right, now do the same thing for the tangent. So you could use the same steps to figure out what the tangent is, multiply both sides by b. You should end up getting that b, so I'm going to use the same color just for consistency, b is actually equal to 8.3 divided by the tangent of 40 degrees. That's going to be the exact answer, but we're going to round this. And so in your calculator, you want to put 8.3 divided by the tangent of 40 degrees. And in my calculator, that rounds to 9.8915, so that's going to be 9.9. All right, so B up here is approximately 9.9. All right, now, the biggest angle is 90 degrees. That means the side opposite that should be the biggest side. So notice the hypotenuse C is the biggest side. The smallest angle is 40 degrees. You should have the smallest side across from that. So 40 degrees, the side opposite that is 8.3. That is the smallest side. So this seems reasonable for an answer. And you can actually go ahead and do the Pythagorean theorem and see if you're close. Now, since I rounded, it's not going to be exact. So let's go ahead and check this using the Pythagorean theorem. All right, so the question is a squared plus b squared, is it approximately equal to c squared? Okay, so let's do that. A squared would be 8.3 squared, and b squared is 9.9 squared. And so go ahead and just put that in your calculator. Do 8.3 squared plus 9.9 squared. I got 166.9. All right, now let's do c squared. C squared is 12.9 squared. So now we want to put that in your calculator. So put in 12.9 and square it in your calculator. And I got 166.41. All right, so that's my check. Close enough. So this means that these are probably the correct answers. I do want to point one thing out. Remember I solved for C first and I got 12.9, I got something else, but I rounded it to 12.9. You do not want to use a rounded answer to figure out B. So if I look back at how I did the problem here, I actually used the exact values I already knew, the tangent of 40 and the 8.3, to find b. Last thing I want to mention is that you need to know at least one side of a right triangle in order to solve it. If all you know are what the three angles are, you won't be able to tell anything about the sides. So as long as you know one side and one of the angles, or if you know two of the sides, you'll be able to solve the right triangle. And what I mean by that is one of the angles besides the right angle. Right, so that's the first triangle solved, and we'll do some more on the next video. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.